Morning everyone, Sairam. Let us do a new chapter in EVS 1, lesson number 23, Natural Disasters. Now, what do you mean by natural disasters? Natural disasters are some dangerous event that happens naturally. It is not man-made. It happens because of imbalance in nature. That is why these incidents or these disasters takes place, which are very dangerous to human as well as animals, as well as plants and everyone on the earth. So let us learn in detail about natural disasters and let us start by learning the new words. The first word is D-I-S-A-S-T-E-R, disaster. Disaster is an event that causes huge damage and lot of damage and it is dangerous for everybody. That is known as disaster. Second one, M-I-S-H-A-P-S, mishaps. Mishaps are some small event which does not cause a great damage, but it is a smaller accident, you can say, okay? A tree falls on the road, but nobody is harmed. So that is a mishap, a small accident which occurs. Third one, H-A-I-L-S-T-O-R-M, hailstorm. Hailstorm are huge balls of ice which falls from the sky, okay? And unexpectedly, they are known as hailstorm. They cause great damage. They hurt a lot. Okay, so hailstorms are dangerous. So hailstorms are huge balls of ice which fall from the sky unexpectedly at any time. Fourth one, E-A-R-T-H-Q-U-A-K-E, earthquake. Earthquake is one of the natural calamity which some imbalance in the earth's surface leads to earthquake. Okay, so that is an earthquake. It is a natural calamity. Fifth one is T-S-U-N-A-M-I, tsunami. Tsunami is again another natural calamity which is caused due to sea waves. Okay, if there is any changes in the sea waves or any incident has taken in the sea because of which the sea has raised its level, the waves are increasing more and more, then tsunami takes place. The sixth one, B-O-W-E-L-S, bowels. Bowels are the earth's movement which occurs under the surface of the earth, that are known as bowels. Now, what are natural disasters that we are going to see first? Many a time we hear of serious mishaps. An earthquake happens here, a flood occurs somewhere else, a storm occurs in one place, another place is struck by lightning. There can be landslide or a hailstorm. So see, sometimes we hear in the news or sometimes we get to know that in some place an earthquake has occurred. Okay, some place flood has occurred or another place place has been struck by lightning or there was a landslide somewhere or a hailstorm or a flood. So all these are natural calamities. It happens, it occurs because there is an imbalance in the nature. And this, for the imbalance in nature, people are responsible. We are responsible because we do not take care of the environment. We use it anyhow we want to in a very, you know, destructive way. And at the time when the earth cannot take these things more and more, natural calamities takes place in the form of earthquake, tsunami, flood, lightning, hailstorm. And these are not man-made. It cannot be stopped by anyone. And when it occurs, it causes a huge damage to all of us. In these incidents, several people are injured. Very, very, very. See, some people also lose their life. Some are severely injured. Some may lose their legs. Some may lose their hand. Some may lose their eyesight. So it is very, very dangerous. Some even lose their lives, okay? Some even die in the natural calamities. Houses collapse, okay? Animals die. Standing crops get destroyed. Houses, which are even strong houses, in case of natural calamities, even they collapse. They also come down. They break. Animals also die. Animals are also, animals are also affected due to this natural calamity. Standing crops means the crops which are grown very well in the fields and are ready for harvest, even they are damaged and destroyed. There is a great damage to property. property means our house, our all the expenses, things are all gone in the natural calamity and we are left with nothing. And most probably some of even people lose their lives. So it is very, very dangerous. Day-to-day life is disturbed and everything is disturbed. Because if we also live during natural calamity, our house is not there, we don't have any personal belongings, our life is in a total mess. It takes several days for life to get back to normal. Yes, not days, it may even take months and years for a life to settle down. Okay, a disaster is a very serious mishap, a very, very dangerous thing. One in which people or animals get injured or die. Animals to people to plants to everything which is in the nature, it gets disrupted. Crops and other property is destroyed. Fields get destroyed, trees, plants, everything. Houses collapse, which is very, very, you know, people lose their house. This is very, a very sad thing, okay? So it should not happen to any one of us. So we should take care of the environment for this. Now, first one is untimely rains. Now, from the word itself, we understand that when it is not a rainy season, it is known as untimely rains. It comes without warning or expectations when we least expect it. Okay? People who have left their houses without umbrella or raincoat have to run helter-skelter for shelter. So, we don't know. See, suppose it is the month of May. So, we do not carry a raincoat and we do not wear our rainy shoes and we don't carry an umbrella. And unexpectedly, it rains during that time. What will happen? We will run here and there. That is helter-skelter means running here and there for finding some particular place where we can find shelter and stand under that roof or under that tree so that we do not get wet. Or they have to get soaked in the rain. And otherwise, the second option is we have to get wet in the rain if we do not find any shelter to stand under. See, this is untimely rains. It is very, very, when it rains for, you know, 3-4 days very, very heavily. Now, what are the effects of untimely rains? Damage of crops. The first effect, the crops are damaged, which are grown very nicely in the fields, they are being damaged. Second is fields get waterlogged. Fields are, you know, full of water, the mud loosens, the crops come out, it is the fields get destroyed. Hailstorm accompanies with untimely rains. So hailstorm, when untimely rains occurs, hailstorm also is accompanied by untimely rains. Now what are hailstorms? I told you they are huge pieces of balls of ice which fall from the sky. Okay, severe hails causes injuries to people and animals. I told you, it is the balls of ice are very, very heavy, and when it comes on the head or anything, it can cause injuries to people as well as animals. It shatters roof tiles. So it is so huge and big that those who don't have, you know, a very strong roof, then that also will come down. It can damage crops in fields and fruits in orchards. It can also damage the fields and fruits also in orchards. A place where fruits are grown is known as orchards. Okay. If mango trees are in blossom at that time, the blossom may rot or fall off. So when it is the time for mango blossoms to grow, and when the hailstorm occurs, it may lead to destruction. This leads to fall in mango production, and that is why mango production comes down. Now, second one is floods. Sometimes during the monsoons, it rains heavily and continuously for 3-4 days. Okay, this causes the level of water in a river to rise. The river gets flooded. If it does not stop raining, settlements on its banks can also get flooded. So what happens during monsoon season? When it rains continuously for 3-4 days, it causes the level of water rises, especially in the low-lying areas. Then the river also gets flooded when the rain does not stop. And the houses which are nearby to the river, settlements, the houses or the villages which are nearby to the river, they also get flooded. See, this is a picture of floods. Okay, people are carrying all their belongings, their children, and the water they are walking. It is very, very sad to see. Now, what are the effects of floods? Mud houses on the riversides collapse during a flood. So, the houses which are not strong, they are made of mud, they fall, they collapse. people and animals may die due to drowning. So the water level is high. Those people who cannot swim, they can die in the water. Flooding of settlements causes problems in everyday life. Settlements means if the houses collapse, if the personal belongings go in the water, everything is, you know, shattered. At such times, we should go to a safe place. Now, what are the precautions we can take place? We should go to a safe place at a height and come back only when the flood water is side. You know, a hill or a mountain which is nearby, you should immediately run towards that place and you will have to sit there till the water level comes back to normal. The current of the flood waters is very strong. It is dangerous to swim in flood waters, yes. Even if you know swimming, but it is in flood waters, you cannot swim properly because the current of that water is very, very strong. Okay, so we can even get drowned in that water. Now, what are earthquakes? Sometimes the rocks in the bowels of the earth move under the ground, that is. As a result, waves are produced in the layers of the rock. And because of that, there are waves underneath the ground which are produced in the layers of the rock. For a few seconds, the ground shakes. Okay, that is called the earthquake. So earthquake is what? When the ground shakes, that is known as earthquake. See, this is the effect of earthquake. The buildings, the houses has collapsed. It occurs only for a few seconds, but it causes damage for a lifetime. Okay? Then everything quietens down again when the earthquake occurs. So there, in that place, everything becomes silent because some people have lost their houses. Houses are... the roads are even cracked in between, the vehicles are shattered here and there. And when the earthquake occurs, I told you it is just for a second, but it damages us for a lifetime. Now, what are the effects? Buildings are shaken, things inside the house all fall from their places. Okay, houses that are not strong enough simply collapse into heaps. People get trapped, get injured, and even lose their life. Buildings fall. If buildings fall, the things inside the houses also fall and break. Then the houses which are not strong, they fall in completely, they become into pieces. And then people who are staying in the houses, if they do not get time to run away from that house, they get trapped and they get injured too. Or they even lose their life. Okay? And the most damage occurs near the center of the earthquake. It also causes injuries or deaths of animals. So at the center means the center of the earth, if there is any building or any roads, whatever, the real damage occurs there. Okay, and it not only harms people, it harms animals, plants, everything in the surrounding. Now, when an earthquake occurs, one should not panic. You should not get scared. What you should do it? Because it lasts for few seconds. During that time, heavy things around us can fall. Okay, so earthquake, when the ground shakes, the things which are heavy, they can fall. So this can cause harm. So soon as we feel the earthquake, we should go under a strong bed or table or stand under a door frame. So always remember, when an earthquake occurs, go under a table, a strong table or a strong bed where you can hide under you can hide yourself underneath that, so that even the things fall, it falls on that table or it falls on the bed and you do not get hurt. So always remember, but it should be strong. Okay, now tsunami, the last one is tsunami. Now there is difference between tsunami and flood. Tsunami is because of the sea waves and floods are because of continuous rainfall. Okay, now if the origin of the earthquake is in the sea, now if earthquake has occurred from the sea itself, it produces gigantic sea waves. Because of that, sea waves are huge and heavy and gigantic. Each wave is the height of 3 or 4 story building. Means a building which is of 3 or 4 floors, that much height is the wave of the tsunami. These waves come with tremendous force towards the coast and crash into the land. And they come with a great force and they crash. And see, this is the picture of tsunami. See, they have come on the road and see the destruction, the light poles, the vehicles around, everything comes down because it is of so much force. These waves are called tsunamis. If there are people living on the coast where a tsunami occurs, it causes much devastation. people or animals who come in the way of these waves are completely helpless. They drown and die. So the people who live along the sea coast, it is very, very dangerous for them. We think, wow, it is so nice for them. They have the sea around them. They can see the view of the sea. But actually, it is very dangerous during this time. Because they are helpless, they cannot run here and there. And then their houses collapse, they are injured, or they even lose their life. A tsunami comes with so much force that vehicles on the coast, along with the people in them, get thrown away to quieter distance. Vehicles are crushed, people inside get injured or die. The tsunami can also shatter houses and shops on the coast. So it can even destroy the vehicles, it can even, you know, destroy the animals, the people, whoever are along the coast. They all may get injured or may they even lose their life. In every city and district headquarters, there is a fixed drill to be followed in case of natural disaster. There are specially trained volunteers for that purpose. So there are special people appointed to help us during these natural calamities. And if necessary, it is very, very, the natural calamity has caused a lot of destructions. Soldiers of the army are also called to help during such time. So people and organization are there who work for help during such natural calamities. And if they are not sufficient, then the soldiers of army are called for help. Okay. Now, what is the recap? We'll take a quick recap of what we studied in today's video. First, we saw about what are natural disasters. Natural disasters are natural calamities which cause great destruction to life, property, animals, and everything around us. And in that, the first one is untimely rains. When it is not a rainy season and it rains continuously and heavily for 3-4 days, which causes destruction to many people, it is called as untimely rains. Second one is flood. Flood occurs due to heavy continuous rainfall, and in low-lying areas it causes a lot of destruction. When the water level rises, the river level rises, the water comes out of the river, and the villages, the houses which are nearby to that place gets destructed. Third one is earthquakes. When some movements take place under the ground, earthquakes occur. And because of earthquakes, buildings, houses, everything collapses. People, property, everything is destroyed. And the last one is tsunami. Tsunami occurs when the earthquake occurs from the sea. The origin is from the sea, then the tsunami takes place. Okay, so these are the four natural calamities which we have studied in today's video. I hope you have understood what I have taught you in today's video. Thank you, children, for listening to me carefully. Goodbye and take care.